Hello all, welcome back to SAI Embedded Automotive. So today we are going to discuss about the Canoe tool. So what is the use of the Canoe tool in automotive industry? So in this video, it contains the how we are going to test the RX frame and TX frame and the node creation. Everything will be explained in this presentation. So let's begin with our presentation and the video. So the agenda of this presentation is like introduction of the Canoe and step-by-step approach to create the Canoe configuration, functional blocks, how to add functional blocks to the simulation, and types of windows are available in the Canoe and its analysis. Let's begin with the Canoe introduction. So what is Canoe? Many people having in the market like PCAN, CAN laser, and Canoe. So Canoe, CAN laser, these are the two families from the vector. So Canoe is a tool where it will test the multiple ECUs, and the CAN laser we can test only the single ECU. So Canoe is a PC based tool from the vector. It is used to test the analyzing the automotive communication protocols like LIN, FlexRay, and Ethernet. Canoe is used to simulate the vehicle environment. The simulation is used to test the actual ECUs. The important note about the Canoe, Canoe is an event driven environment. The function are called on a trigger of an event. Some event that triggers the function called like a key pressed, timer expired, and CAN message reception. Like, we'll discuss step by step approach to create the Canoe configuration. There are three building blocks of Canoe configuration as follows. One is DBC creation, that we call it as .dbc. So it is used to create the messages for the Canoe. We will create the messages and signals in the DBC. So you can also download the demo version of DBC configurator .dB editor, and the designing tools like .cnp, it is for panel designer, and the CAPL scripting is used for the write the CAPL for the event based frames. So this is the window which is when we open the Canoe setup. So file, we have the new configuration is there, and inside that we have different types of templates we are using, like example Ethernet, FlexRay, and J1939 are default template. So and another one is the setting the baud rate. Actually, why baud rate is configured in this tool? Like, we have four types of baud rates are based on the CAN ISO. One is 125 kbps, 250 kbps, 500 kbps, and 1000 kbps baud rate is available. So here we are going to configure the baud rate. Network hardware if we go, then if you select CAN channel 1 and CAN channel 2, this is two channels of the Canoe. There if you see the type, we call it as a CAN case XL, and what is a microcontroller, it is a Philips, now it is NXP microcontroller, and here the baud rate we have selected 500 kbps baud rate. Then we need to click on OK. Then the creating the baud rate, what is the purpose of creating the baud rate? The primary things need to set up the creation of the baud rate is the database mainly consists of the signals, messages, environment, environmental variables, and nodes, etc. So how we are going to access the database editor, means the DBC file, how we are going to add? If you see left side, we will insert this DBC file with respect to CAN, LIN, FlexRay, or Ethernet. So create a DBC. So if we have multiple types of DBCs are there. One is with respect to the Ethernet DBC, CAN DBC, and so many. So if we are going to create a DBC file for the respective diagnostic, that tool is called Candela tool. That is the difference. Okay. Next, after that, creating the environmental variables, like it is basic things only, like it is used to create the some variables, like some similar purpose of variables we can use like to create that environmental variables. So that how we are going to create the messages here. So right click, if we open the right click inside the messages, so we have the message properties are there. So what are the message properties are there? Message name, whether it is a standard or extended. Message ID, whether it is a standard means it's 11 bit. If it is a extended means 29 bit message identifier. And the DLC rate, it will be 8 bytes. And the cyclic time, we call it as a raster or timing parameters. Next, after creating one message, we need to create one signal. Similar way, right click the respective signal name and its length, whether it is a byte order, whether it is a Intel or a Motorola. So these two topics we have already covered in the previous video, so you can please go through. Like we call it as the Indians, little Indian and big Indian, it will decide. Mostly little Indian will be used the Intel microcontroller and big Indian used for the Motorola microcontroller. And here we have the properties like unit, initial value, maximum value, minimum value, and all these things will be available in the CAN matrix sheet. Like when you are configuring any kind of a CAN message, the customer or the client will provide the respective CAN matrix sheet. Based on the CAN matrix sheet, you people will be configured according to the requirement. How we are going to link the signals to the message? Just go to that message and open, choose that option and link the respective message. After configuring the database, the similar way we need to link the database to the project. Same, like add, right click, select, choose the created database from the our local PC. Next, here we have the panel design. The second aspect we call it as a panel design. Like each signal in the message will be configured by the means various like radio button, slider, switches, etc. Panel provides a way to manually control the signal they're controlling the message. For example, if I am having the acceleration message property, so if I want to press that acceleration button till 200 kmps, or how we are going to just to it is like a simulation setup we are doing in the Canoe. So that design, everything will be done in the panel design mode. Next, how we are going to access this panel design? So if you see there, one panel designer symbol will be there. If you click that one, then the panel design will be open. So this is the radio button, and the radio button properties also we can give, and we can also change the color, and we can also give the respective control and size, everything. Next, attaching the environmental variables. Similarly, attach the environmental variables for the all control chosen. Mostly when we are using this control buttons or anything, we can also attach the environmental variables. Opening the panel. So how we are going to open this panel? Just view, click on open the panel. If you see view, open the panel, you can see the panel. Next, here we can I discussed already. So adjusting the panel, we can control the data by sending the messages, and respective messages we can also observe in the trace window or the graphical window or data or write window. Mostly write window is used to write the CAPL scripting. Next, how many types of functional blocks are there? So we have three types of functional blocks are there. One is IG block and logging block and replay block. So IG block, the full form of the IG block is interactive generator block. So whatever the data we are sending from the input, like in the IG block, the data will be appear in the trace window. Similar like logging block and the replay block. So this is about the IG block. With the interactive generator block, you can configure send a message while measuring is running. How we are going to add this IG block? If you open the one particular node, just right click, insert the IG block. There you can see the IG block. So if you see the IG block, how we are going to configure, like message name, identifier, which channel we are going to send, whether it is a channel 1 or channel 2, channel 3 or channel 4. If it is a 4 channel CANCAS XL, we can send all the 4 types of baud rate, and the frame, whether it is a data frame or a remote frame, DLC, either 8 bytes. Or if it is more than 8 bytes, then we can send the CANTP format. Next, logging window. So logging window is like block. We can record the events happening in the bus, like it's saved in the dot binary file format. So that will be add similar like represent in the presentation. So right click, and login configuration is there. So if you see login file configuration there, you can log the output. Means in generally logs is used to shown to the our test case is working as per our requirement or not. So and coming to here, we have types of formats also there, dot ASIL, ASIC, and the respective formats we can use, like binary format and the can dot can everything. Coming to the replay block, the recorded events can be replayed by giving the dot blf file, and source how to create the configure I just shown in this presentation. So similar way, right click on the current can bus and select insert the replay block can. This is also like the functional block simulation, how we are going to simulate here in the local. This is what we are going to insert the notes. This presentation already covered in the previous slide. So how many types of windows are there? So here we have measurement window, static window, trace window, data window, graphical window, and write window. So measurement window represents the setup, whether the configuration is established, everything will be in the measurement window. Simulation window looks like this. And this is the trace window, we call it as the output we can measure here. This is static window, and this is the trace window. So in the trace window, whatever the data we are passing from the IG block, that will be appear in the trace window. Next, this is data window. So it is used to display the signal value. The signal value is displayed as the physical value, raw value, with the progress by default. This is the graphical view. So we can also view our things, the expected output in the graphical view. So this is the write window. So it is used to write the CAPL program. After that, we can compile and we can run the CAPL programming. So mainly what is CAPL means, CAN accessing programming language, allows to use to quick develop the code, makes the Canoe simulation more driven. CAPL is a procedure language whereby executing the program blocks is controlled by the events. These program blocks are also known as the event procedure. So CAPL is having the three parts. One is global variable declaration, event procedure, and user defined functions. How we are going to access the CAPL browser? You have to see in like one pencil symbol is there, just you click that, so the CAPL browser will be open. There you can use the respective CAPL programming, and you can execute also well. So once again, thanks for watching this video, and please do like, share, and subscribe. And we are happily announcing like we got around 500 plus subscribers, and we are going to providing the end-to-end support to the respective experienced and fresher people. So please do subscribe, share, and like. Thank you.